मॉर्निंग
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द डायरेक्टिविटी गेन एटी बीम एफिशिएंसी एंड द रेडिएशन एफिशिएंसी। सो द नेक्स्ट वी हैव सर्टेन प्रॉब्लम्स व्हिच आर रिलेटेड टू डायरेक्टिविटी। So where you will be studying about the unidirectional pattern and the bidirectional pattern. Now this is called as the calculation of directivity of various sources. So you need to find out what is the directivity of the sources which is given based on the unidirectional pattern or bidirectional pattern. Here, the important points you need to note down here is when you consider unidirectional pattern, whenever the question is given for unidirectional pattern, the theta value varies from 0 to pi by 2. Directly, they'll not be giving you the values. They'll directly give you unidirectional pattern and bidirectional pattern. So when it is unidirectional pattern, it means it is theta will be varying from 0 to pi by 2. Similarly, when you consider a bidirectional pattern, if it is a bidirectional pattern, theta will be varying from 0 to 180. That is 0 to pi. Remember these two points, unidirectional, theta should be 0 to pi by 2, whereas bidirectional, it should be 0 to pi, that is 0 to 180. And always, directivity of the bidirectional pattern, is always equal to half of that unidirectional pattern. So once you find out the pattern, unidirectional or bidirectional directivity, you will be knowing the answer of the other one, that is bidirectional or a unidirectional. If unidirectional is given and if you are told to find out bidirectional, then you know that it is twice. If it is bidirectional pattern given to find out, and if you have to find out the unidirectional, you know it is half of unidirectional. So using this, you can verify your answers, whether the directivity answers what you are getting is correct or not. So we'll do the problems based on that. Let's share the screen. The first question I want you to write down, unidirectional cosine pattern. Unidirectional cosine pattern. Now here, the direct question what is given, everything will be in terms of the radiation. The question will not be mentioned what is it actually. So all the patterns, whatever you take, it is in terms of radiation intensity. So whenever you write the pattern, this pattern, what is given, unidirectional cosine pattern, it will be equal to your U. That is, radiation intensity is represented as U. So, which is equal to UM cos theta. Whenever it is unidirectional sine pattern, it will have the equation U is equal to UM cos theta. Similarly, if it is unidirectional sine pattern, you have to take UM sine theta. Similarly, sine square, sine cube, like that. Now we'll solve this. The first step what you have to take is, or what you have to consider is, you know the directivity formula. Understand the problem, because we have like this 16 problems to solve. So first step, you should be knowing what exactly you're solving. So first is write down the formula of directivity. That is 4 pi UM divided by power radiated. So this is the directivity formula. But we know that power radiated formula is double integral varying from phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. This doesn't change. Now, since it is given unidirectional, what should be the theta variation?
0 to 2 pi.
Yeah, 0 to pi. Pi or pi by 2?
Pi by 2.
Unidirectional, it is pi by 2. So I'll consider directly theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. And the pattern what is given is, or the formula is u sin theta d theta d phi, where your sin theta d phi is a solid angle. Now substitute the question, that is radiation intensity what is given. So that is 0 to 2 pi. Theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. U is um cos theta sin theta d theta d phi. The next thing, now take out the common terms, whichever is required. Pi terms you bring it one side and the theta terms. So power radiated is equal to um is a constant, I take it outside. Phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi, this is d phi. Theta will be equal to 0 to pi by 2. You have cos theta, sin theta, d theta. Now tell me how to do the integration of this.
Ma'am, cos theta, sin theta can be written as sin 2 theta by 2, ma'am.
Yes, correct. You have a formula for sin 2 theta. So which is equal to sin 2 theta, which is equal to 2 cos theta into sin theta. So you need actually here for, cos theta sin theta. So you can write it from this formula as cos theta sin theta is equal to sin 2 theta by 2. So I'll substitute it here. So power radiated is equal to um, phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi d phi. Similarly, theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. Cos theta sin theta is sin 2 theta divided by 2 into d theta. Now you need to do the integration. Again here I can take out 2 outside common. Now integration of d phi is phi varying from 0 to 2 pi. Similarly, what is integration of sin 2 theta? Integration of sin theta is
minus cos theta.
So what will be integration of sin 2 theta?
Minus cos 2 theta divided by 2.
Yeah, correct. Minus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So here it will be minus cos 2 theta divided by 2, varying the limit from 0 to pi by 2. Now substitute the limits. Again here I can take this 2 outside. So it will be um by 4. And substitute the pi value. 2 pi minus 0. So you'll get 2 pi. Here, make sure almost everybody does mistake here. It's always, there is a negative sign. Whenever you apply the limit, be careful. So it is minus cos 2 into theta value is pi by 2. Again, it is minus. So minus into minus, it will be plus. Here cos 2 into 0. So you will have the value for this. Just a minute, I'll erase this. So you will have the value of power radiated as um by 4, and you have 2 pi here. This is 2 and 2 will get cancelled. You have minus cos pi. You know, cos pi value is minus 1. So it is minus into minus 1 plus cos 2 into 0. It is cos 0. Cos 0 value is 1. So finally, you have an equation minus into minus, it's plus. 1 plus 1, it is 2. So it is 2 into 2, 4 pi. So it is 4 pi um by 4. This and this will get cancelled. You have pi into um. So this is the power radiated. Once you get the power radiated, substitute in the directivity. So it is 4 pi um divided by power radiated. What you have got is pi into um. So this and this will cancel. So the unidirectional cosine pattern will have a directivity that is 4. For bidirectional, you know the answer directly. How much it should be? How much you must be getting?
2, ma'am.
Yeah, 2. So for bidirectional, you'll be getting it as 2. Should I explain once again problem? Consider the directivity formula. Yeah. U is equal to Um sine theta, cos theta is the question given. Directivity formula is 4 pi Um by power radiated. You need to calculate power radiated. The equation of power radiated is pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Theta is equal to 0 to pi is the general equation. Since we are taking here unidirectional, we will consider it as 0 to pi by 2. U sine theta d theta d phi. And almost everybody missed this part. You'll not be writing this part. So make sure you have to write this d omega. And substitute u value. You know it is um cos theta sine theta d theta d phi. Now whenever you have cos theta d theta, either you can go for substitution also. But here we know the formula of sine 2 theta. It is 2 cos theta sine theta, where you can just directly relate this cos theta sine theta as sine 2 theta by 2. Substitute for sine theta and cos theta as sine 2 theta by 2. Now do the integration part. D phi integration is phi. Apply the limit 0 to 2 pi. Sine 2 theta by 2, it is minus cos 2 theta by 2. 0 to pi by 2. Now apply the limits. 2 pi minus 0 is 2 pi. Cos 2 theta you have, because I have taken outside the divided by 2 term, what is there, that I have taken it outside. So you'll have only minus cos 2 theta. So minus cos 2 theta value is pi by 2. Minus into minus will be plus, and cos 2 into 0. So you will have cos pi here after 2 and 2 gets cancelled. Again, cos pi value is minus 1 and cos 0 value is 1. So minus into minus, it will be plus, plus 1. So this is totally 2. 2 into 2 is 4 pi um divided by 4. 4 and 4 get cancelled. You will have pi um. So directivity formula you substitute for power radiated as pi um, it gets cancelled and you will have the directivity of unidirectional cosine pattern as 4. Clear? Okay, I'll clear the screen.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now, we will do one bidirectional pattern, that is bidirectional cosine pattern. Now the question remains same, that is u is equal to um cos theta. You know directivity formula is, it is 4 pi um divided by power radiated. You need to find out what is power radiated. So power radiated is equal to phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. You need to write the formula because there is marks for formula also. And then theta is equal to. Now, what is the value of theta here ranging bidirectional? 0 to pi. So 0 to pi u sine theta d phi. The next step, substitute u. Phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Theta is equal to 0 to pi. Um cos theta sine theta d phi. Again, next procedure we usually do, relate the terms of phi and d theta. You have theta is equal to 0 to pi. Um, I'll take it outside. So you have cos theta sine theta d theta. Now what is the next step? Same. Substitute as. Is it same? Substituting sine 2 theta here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So power radiated is equal to um integral 0 to pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Theta is equal to 0 to pi. Sine 2 theta by 2 into d theta. So because sine 2 theta is equal to cos theta into sine theta. So we will be writing in terms of cos theta sine theta as this is not half, this is 2. So it is 1 by 2 sine 2 theta. Okay. Now, doing the integration part, you have here 2 pi integration of d phi is phi 0 to 2 pi. This integration again, it is minus cos 2 theta by 2. So you have the integration 0 to pi. Where here it will be um and this is 2 pi minus 0. There is one more 2 from here. So the remaining is minus cos 2 into the unit, sorry, the limit is pi minus into minus plus. This is cos 0. Now what is the answer?
Cos 2 pi is?
What is cos 2 pi?
One more.
So minus into minus minus plus. What is cos 0?
Again,
one. So what is the answer?
Zero.
But you know that unidirectional answer should, sorry, bidirectional answer must be 2. But you are getting 0. What is the problem? See, the integration of the terms certain problems. Now, if you see this power radiated, it is 0. If I substitute it here, it is 4 pi um by 0, which means directivity is infinity, which is not correct. So here, when you have such cases where your power radiated, you're getting it as 0. That means your limit value must be changed. So here, tell you the procedure, what you have to do actually. So since you're getting it as 0, so the problem with the limit, there is a formula in integration. What is that when you have 0 to pi, you need to change the limit to other same, like for example, it is pi by 2, I have to change. There is a formula to change. Do you remember integration? Since directivity cannot be equal to infinity in practical cases, you have to use the property of definite integral. Anybody can say what is the property? Definite integrals. Now, what does this property say is, suppose if I am valuing the value of theta as 0 to pi x into dx. This is actually the form what we have here. I need to change this limit so that my answer should not be 0. The property says, if you multiply 2 and theta is varying from 0 to pi by 2 into x into dx, provided that x should be an odd function. We know that for an odd function, f of minus x should be equal to minus f of x. So here you have to apply this formula. Whenever you are changing the limit, multiply it by 2 and change the limit to 0 to pi by 2. Since x is an odd function, you will be considering f of minus x is equal to f of x property. So can you tell me what exactly happens here? For example, if I'm taking or leave that question. For example, integration of sine theta. This is my f of x. So if I have to change it, your integration of sine theta, you know it is cos theta. But say the limit should be changed to 0 to pi x dx should be equal to 2 times of 0 to pi by 2 multiplied with 2, that is x into dx. So here sine of minus theta will be equal to minus sine theta. So this is what is odd function. Now similar way we will apply it here. Understood the property? Remember this property, definite integral. 0 to pi x dx should be equal to 2 times of 0 to pi by 2 x into dx. One more thing you will understand once you substitute it here. The next step, what you are doing, you substitute the formula directly here, sine 2 theta. You know it is um, phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi d phi, theta is equal to 0 to pi. The formula is sine 2 theta by 2 d theta. Now we are supposed to change the limit. So it is um by 2, I'll take it outside. Phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi into d phi. So this is the normal phi term. Now what you have to do here to this term, if I apply this definite integral property for sine 2 theta, apply this, what happens? The first thing is
2 into integral of 0 to pi by 2.
2 into integral of 0 to pi by 2 sine 2 theta. Yeah, sine 2 theta into d theta. Now we are supposed to do the integration. Now when you do the integration, the same process. Once you change the limit, rest all process remains same. The only thing is you should understand when to change the limits. So here, do the integration part now. So which is equal to um, you can see 2 here, we'll take it outside. D phi integration is phi, which is varying from 0 to 2 pi. Similarly, sine 2 theta integration is minus cos 2 theta by 2, the limit varying from 0 to pi by 2. So now substitute the limits. The first term 2 and 2 gets cancelled here along with um. So you have only um, 2 pi minus 0 is 2 pi. You have one more 2 here, take it outside. And minus cos 2 into limit is pi by 2, minus into minus plus cos 2 into 0. So you have 2 and 2 again gets cancelled. Um pi, this is minus cos 2 pi value, it is 1 plus cos 0 value is 0. Sorry, one second. It's a mistake. Just a minute. Cos 2 pi value is minus 1. Is there anything?
Ma'am.
Yeah, tell me.
Ma'am, here you are already cancelled too, ma'am. Um by 2, you are already cancelled it.
Yeah, this is the limit of 2 pi and the 2 which is in the denominator. 2 pi by 2. Clear? This 2 I have cancelled. This is the integrated 2 which I have taken in the denominator and the 2 pi after applying the limit here. 2 pi by 2. Is that okay?
Yeah, ma'am.
Okay. Now you have here is 2 and 2 will get cancelled. You have cos pi. Cos pi value is minus 1 plus again cos 0 value is plus 1. So you have 1 plus 1, it is 2. So 2 pi um is a power radiated what you're getting. Now you have to apply it to the formula of directivity. To apply it to the formula of directivity, you know that the formula is plus 1. The formula is D is equal to 4 pi um by power radiated, which is equal to 4 pi um divided by 2 pi um, which gives you the value of directivity as 2, which means the unidirectional pattern what we are getting is correct. 2 into 2 will give you the, bidirectional pattern what you are getting is correct, that is 2. 2 into 2 if you do, you will get 4, which is the unidirectional pattern. Is it clear? You want me to explain once again? No or yes?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So remember this step. The very important step here is whenever the limit you have to change, suppose you are power radiated, the answer you are getting 0, change the limit to 0 to pi by 2 by multiplying it by 2 and putting the limit as 0 to pi by 2. Okay. So I clear the screen. The next problem which we are doing is unidirectional sine pattern. You also can try doing same procedure it is, unidirectional sine pattern. Now you have u is equal to um sine theta. What is the first step you have to do? Write down the formulas. Directivity is 4 pi um by power radiated, where power radiated formula is phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. This is unidirectional. So theta should vary from 0 to pi by 2. U sine theta d phi. So substitute u here. Phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. U m. Again, this step is very important. Almost everybody does mistake. Sine theta you have, and there is one more sine theta. So don't forget to multiply that sine theta here. So sine theta, you'll get sine square theta here. So phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. Um, I'll take it outside. You have sine square theta d phi. Now split the terms. Power radiated is equal to um integral phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi d phi. Theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2 sine square theta d theta. Now tell me how to do the integration of sine square theta.
Sine square theta can be written as 1 minus cos 2 theta.
Yes, exactly. So here the sine square theta formula, you have actually the formula for cos 2 theta. So cos 2 theta is equal to, it is 1 minus, cos 2 theta is equal to 1 minus 2 sine square theta. Correct?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now you have to write for sine square theta. So you have 2 sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta, where sine square theta will be equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. So you need to remember the formulas. So sine square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. Now substitute it here. So you'll have power radiated is equal to um integral of phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi d phi. This is again integral of theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. And now put a bracket because you have two terms there, 1 by 2 and cos 2 theta by 2. So you need to apply the derivation for two cases. One is d theta and one is cos 2 theta. Now, next step, power radiated is equal to, you can bring this 2 here outside. So you have um by 2 and phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi d phi. Now see here, split the limit first. Theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. The first term what you have is 1 because I've already taken 2 outside. 1 into d theta is the first term. So this is 1 into d theta minus integral of theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. The other term what you have is cos 2 theta by 2. Sorry, cos 2 theta into d theta. So these are the other terms what you have. So split the terms and write 1 into d theta will give you d theta minus cos 2 theta into d theta. Erase this part. Start doing the integration of this. So when you do the integration, first integration of the term that is phi, you know it is 2 pi directly. So it is power radiated is equal to um divided by 2 d phi integration is phi, varying the limit from 0 to 2 pi. The next term what you have, that is d theta. D theta integration is theta, which is 0 to pi by 2. What is integration of cos 2 theta, or integration of cos theta is?
Sine theta.
Sine theta. So integration of cos 2 theta is?
Sine 2 theta by 2.
Sine 2 theta divided by 2. Now substitute it here. That is sine 2 theta divided by 2. Apply the limit 0 to pi by 2. Now when you apply the limit, it is um by 2. Here it is 2 pi minus 0, which will be getting it as 2 pi. Again here, pi by 2 minus 0 will be pi by 2 minus, you have by 2 here. You can take it outside for simplification purpose, or you can keep it like that, no problem. The next limit you have is sine 2 theta. Instead of theta, it is pi by 2 minus sine 0. I'll write it directly. We know sine 0 is 0. So this is one term. You can 2 and 2 will get cancelled. You will have um pi into pi. It is pi square. Sorry, one just a minute. This is inside the bracket. So it is um into pi. This is pi by 2 minus 2 and 2 will get cancelled. What is sine pi?
0.
0. So this whole term will become 0. We know sine 0 also 0. This is also 0. So you have only the term left, that is pi by 2. So you will have um pi square by 2. So this is the power radiated of unidirectional sine pattern. Now apply this limit, apply the power radiated to the directivity formula. That is D is equal to 4 pi um by power radiated. So which is again equal to 4 pi um divided by power radiated is um pi square by 2. So it is 2 into 4 will be 8 pi um by pi square um. um gets cancelled. 1 pi and 1 pi will get cancelled. It will be 8 by pi. What is 8 by pi in decimal? Just check. What is 8 by pi in decimal?
2.546.
2.546, or it is approximately equal to 2.55. Any confusion here? Should I explain once again? Others? So just try the formula, substitute. You should be knowing the integration formulas. So trigonometry formulas, if you know, doing the integration will be very easy. And make sure each and every step is done properly, because if you miss the integration or applying the limits, whole answer gets changed. Okay, so we'll move on to the next one. Will you solve bidirectional income tomorrow when you come?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Then we'll move to the square pattern now. Write down there, you have to solve bidirectional sine pattern. What should be the answer you might be getting? For unidirectional, you got 8 by pi. What should be for bidirectional? Divide this by 2. How much you'll get? 8 by pi divided by 2.
1.27.
Yeah, 4 by pi, or it is 1.27. So solve this and come. Now write down the next question. We'll solve one more. It is unidirectional. Unidirectional cosine square pattern. So your u will be um cos square theta here. So we'll solve. Directivity is 4 pi um by power radiated. Power radiated is equal to phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. It is unidirectional. So theta will be pi by 2. U sine theta d phi, which is again equal to phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. Substitute the value of u, um cos square theta sine theta d phi. So um, I'll take it outside. Phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi d phi. Theta is equal to 0 to pi by 2. Cos square theta sine theta d theta. How to do the integration now? Integration of this. Cos square theta, sine theta.
Mom, substitution method, mom.
Yeah, correct. You can, whenever you have like this kind of pattern, go for substitution methods. Which one I have to take it as T? Cos theta or sine theta?
Cos theta, mom.
Cos theta. Whenever there is substitution method, you can go for the terms which is having squares. So consider cos theta is equal to T. You need to differentiate. What is differentiation of sine theta? Differentiation of sine, sorry, cos theta.
Sine theta.
Is it just sine theta or minus sine theta?
Minus sine theta.
Minus sine theta d theta is equal to dt. Check here, we need d theta actually. Sine t theta, d theta. So if I write in terms of sine theta into d theta, it is minus dt. Now in substitution method, whenever you substitute for theta as t, you know the limits has to be changed. So first value, when theta is equal to 0, what is t? So cos 0 is equal to t. So t is equal to cos 0 is 1. One more value, when theta is equal to pi by 2, cos pi by 2 is equal to t. So t should be equal to cos pi by 2 is 0. Yeah. Now substitute the values here. So it is um, pi is equal to 0 to 2 pi d phi. Integral of theta is, sorry, t is equal to, whenever theta is 0, you know the value of t is 1. And pi by 2, it is 0. Instead of cos square theta, I should write it as t square. And for sine theta d theta, you know it is minus dt. Now, what is the next step you have to do here? What is next?
Ma'am, we can interchange the limits, ma'am.
You have to interchange the limit. We know that if you have something like 1 to 0, it will be using the negative sign and changing the limit to 0 to t. You already have a negative sign here. So it is like change the limit to 0 to 1. This is t square into dt. So now do the integration part. You know d phi integration is phi, varying the limit from 0 to 2 pi. What about t square integration?
T cube by 3.
T cube by 3. Integration 0 to 1. So it is um, integration limits 2 pi minus 0 is 2 pi. I take 3 outside. T cube is 1 cube minus 1 to the power 0. How much is that? 1 to the power 0 is always 0. So 1 to the power cube is 1. So you have 2 pi um by 3, the power radiated. Now substitute it to the directivity formula. So you have 4 pi um divided by 2 pi um by 3. I'm writing it here only. You have to write the formula after this, then continue it. So 4 pi um by 3, 2 pi um by 3. So it is 2 pi um gets cancelled. So it is 2 and it is 3 2s are 6. So the directivity of unidirectional cos square pattern is 6. Is that okay? Any confusions? Now I want you to solve and come for bidirectional. Bidirectional cosine square pattern. Just, you know, the answer should be 3. Try it and come. Clear the screen. We'll solve one more sine square pattern.
Yes, ma'am.
Unidirectional or bidirectional?
Bidirectional.
We'll go for bidirectional. That means unidirectional, you need to solve. Bidirectional sine square pattern. So your u will be equal to um sine square theta. Write down the formula. T is 4 pi um by power radiated. power radiated is equal to theta is equal to, sorry, phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Bidirectional it is, so 0 to pi u sine theta d theta d phi. Now apply the value of u. Phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Theta is equal to 0 to pi. Um sine square theta, you have one more sine theta here, d theta d phi. So the total value, I'll take um outside, phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi d phi, theta is 0 to pi, sine square into sine theta will be sine cube theta d theta. Now tell me what is the integration of sine cube theta. How to do the integration of sine cube? Tell me
using
what is
sine 3 theta.
Correct. Formula. What is sine formula of sine 3 theta? The sine 3 theta formula. Tell me what is sine cube theta formula, not sine 3 theta. No idea? Sine cube theta is 3 sine theta, minus sine 3 theta by 4. Okay. Sine cube theta is 3 sine theta minus sine 3 theta by 4. Now substitute this here. So you have power radiated is equal to um, phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi d phi. Have theta is equal to 0 to pi. It is 3 sine theta minus sine 3 theta by 4 d theta integration. Now be careful when you take out, I mean when you put the limit as well as integrating it. So you will take, I have taken 4 outside. You have to, you have 0 to 2 pi d phi. Split the equations. Theta is equal to 0 to pi. First equation you have 3 sine theta, because 4 I have taken outside. 3 sine theta d theta. Next, minus theta is equal to 0 to pi sine 3 theta d theta. Now do the integration. Um by 4, this is, you know, it is 2 pi. I mean phi is equal to 0 to 2 pi. Integrate, applying the limits. What is integration of 3 sine theta? 3 will be constant. Integration of sine theta.
Minus cos theta.
Minus cos theta. Integration 0 to pi. What about sine 3 theta?
Minus cos
3 theta by 3.
Minus cos 3 theta by 3. You have 0 to pi. Again, here there is one more negative sign. There is one more negative sign. So you have to be again, be careful when applying the limit. Just a minute, I'll erase this. You can continue, those who are doing it. Those who did not understand or you want to see the step, change. So power radiated is equal to um by 4. This is 2 pi minus 0. So this will remain as 2 pi. Now here, 3 into the first limit, what you have? Minus cos pi. So it will be minus cos pi. Minus into minus, you have one more negative here. Minus into minus will be plus. This is cos 0. So this is one term. Again, minus 1 by 3 I can take outside. You have minus cos 3 pi. Minus cos 3 pi. Minus into minus plus. You have cos 0. Remember, minus is there in cos. Minus cos pi. Minus into minus plus cos 0. This minus I have kept it outside. So minus cos 3 pi. Minus into minus plus cos 0. Now apply the values of cos. So you have 2 pi here. This is 4. So the first term, 3 into what is cos pi? it is minus 1. So minus 1 into minus. So here you have negative. This is minus 1 plus cos 0 is 1. This is 1 minus, you have 1 by 3. What is cos 3 pi? Cos 3 pi value?
Minus 1.
So you have already minus here. This will be again minus 1 plus cos 0 is 1. So here is the step where you miss usually because of the signs, the answers. So solve it carefully when you solve. So this is 2, 2. This will get cancelled. You have um pi. What is minus into minus is plus 1. 1 plus 1 will be 2. 2 into 3 will be 6. Minus. Here, this 2 are bound with this negative. So make sure it is inside the bracket only. So this is 1 by 3. You have minus into minus plus. Again plus 1. You have 2 by 3 total. So here it is um pi. 6 threes are 18. 18 minus 2 is 16. So you will have 16 by 3. So the total power radiated what you are getting here is 16 pi um by 3. Now apply to the formula of directivity. So D will be equal to 4 pi.
Ma'am, that is 16 pi.
Is there any mistake?
Um pi by 2, previous one.
Ah, yeah, the 2 was missing. Okay, thank you.
So
this
eight,
is 2, this will be 8. Yeah, correct. So this is 8 pi um by 3. So you have the directivity formula, power radiated, substituted 4 pi um by 8 pi um by 3. So this is cancelled. This is 2 times of this. You will have 3 by 2, which is 1.5. So the directivity of bidirectional cosine pattern is 1.5. Any confusions? I hope there is nothing. So when you come tomorrow, is there anybody writing? You come, you have to solve bidirectional. Which all the questions were given? One is bidirectional cos square theta. Then it was
bidirectional sine pattern, mom.
Bidirectional sine pattern. And it is
sine square pattern.
Oh, unidirectional sine square theta pattern. So solve this and come. I want everybody to try it. Please don't simply just listen. Try and come. If the answers you know, because you have already solved either unidirectional or bidirectional answers you are knowing. The only thing is be careful when you apply the limits and check if you are getting power radiated integration as zero. Change the limit. And one more thing, the bidirectional sine square pattern which we have seen now, that bidirectional sine square pattern, it can also be called as source width Duffner pattern. So I want you to write down this name, because sometimes the question will not be asked as directly to solve bidirectional sine square pattern. They will ask you to find out the directivity of source with Duffner pattern. So bidirectional sine square theta pattern is also called as source with Duffner pattern. So any